Hello, my dear friends. Welcome to the Daily Dose. I'm myself, Dr. Rajesh Gupta. I'm a cardiologist, and I'm also the mentor for teaching general medicine for exams like NEET PG, AIMS, PGI, and as well as JIPMA. So, as a part of today's Daily Dose, the question is on the APLA syndrome, that is antiphospholipid antibody syndrome. Let me discuss about that. The question is, lupus anticoagulant causes all except. The options are recurrent abortions, arterial thrombosis, increased APTT, nephritis. Now, so you should know what exactly is your lupus anticoagulant. Lupus anticoagulant is actually an antibody, right? It is an immunoglobulin. And this particular immunoglobulin, it is due to the presence of the phospholipids and as well as the proteins which are present within the cell wall. So lupus anticoagulant is basically an antibody to the phospholipid and proteins which are present within the cell membrane. Now, it is a prothrombotic agent. That means it has the property of increased tendency of blood clotting. And because of this particular increased tendency of the blood clotting, it can cause thrombosis in the uterine, venous, and as well as the arterial thrombosis, right? Thereby, the blood supply to the fetus reduces, and that will result in what is called as the recurrent abortions. So remember, recurrent abortions is the feature of your APLA syndrome or your lupus anticoagulant. Now, what are the antibodies in your APLA syndrome? The antibodies in your APLA syndrome, remember, this is a very, very important question. In antiphospholipid antibody syndrome, the antibodies are lupus anticoagulant, anticardiolipin antibody, and anti-beta 2 glycoprotein. These are the three important antibodies like what you'll have in this APLA syndrome. And if you take this APLA syndrome, the incidence of this APLA syndrome in the general population is around 5%. But the incidence of APLA syndrome in patients with SLE is nearly around 50%. So this is a very, very important point, right? Now, what will be the clinical manifestations of your APLA syndrome? See, the clinical manifestations, everything will be related to your clotting process. That is the formation of thrombus. Number one, because of reduced blood supply to the fetus, they can have recurrent spontaneous abortion. And because of the formation of the clot within the cerebral vasculature, the individual can develop cerebrovascular accidents, transient ischemic attack, and as well as the dementia. They can also have arterial and venous thromboembolism. They can have various dermatological manifestations, cardiopulmonary manifestations, and as well as coagulopathy. And ultimately, what is the treatment for these patients? You need to give anticoagulants, right? You need to give anticoagulants for that particular thrombus, okay? And very important aspect is the antibodies. The investigation of choice is your antibodies. Lupus anticoagulant, anticardiolipin antibody, and as well as anti-beta 2 glycoprotein. Right? So going back to the question, lupus anticoagulant causes all. It will cause your recurrent abortions. It will also cause arterial thrombosis. Right? And there will be also increased APTT. Right? Why? Because of the lupus anticoagulant being procoagulant or a prothrombotic agent where there is increased tendency of the thrombus formation. So there is increased APTT also. But the one which you will not see is your nephritis. Nephritis is not a part of your lupus anticoagulant or your APLA syndrome. So that is a part of today's Daily Dose. That is about the APLA syndrome. So I hope like you have liked this particular short video on the APLA syndrome. Right? And do follow us on the Daily Dose. Thank you very much.